Hello everyone, it's Brian Stites with the Twin Cities Real Estate Guide reporting live here in Minnesota on the state of our real estate market. If you're new to our channel or have never subscribed, feel free to go ahead and subscribe right now and give us a like. I'd also like to welcome any comments. We'd love to answer any of your questions. So let's go ahead and get started. Lately, I've been getting the question, how is the real estate market? Will the US real estate market crash in 2020 due to the economic concerns spawned by the COVID virus? According to the National Association of Realtors, that's a hard question to answer at the moment. And mainly because we don't know how long the situation will drag on. That's the key factor here, is the duration of the crisis. But as of right now, it seems unlikely that we'll see a nationwide housing crash on the scale of the one we did in 2008. What's more likely is that the real estate market will slow down as a few home buyers venture out to buy houses. This in turn could lead to a slower home price growth going forward. So I wanted to answer it with a video. I think many of you will be surprised by the answer, and some of it make sense and some of it doesn't make sense. So stick around to the end for my bold 2020 prediction. March stock market declines and volatility across the financial markets, massive layoffs, lenders tightening underwriting standards, and social distancing efforts have all combined to put some buyers and sellers on the sidelines for now. As the spread and effect of COVID-19 accelerate during the month, we will need to wait until next month to see the total impact to buyers and sellers and the activity. I'll show you a couple of charts that at least my geek friends will find interesting. We will analyze it all at the end. So first, pending sales, which are properties that have an accepted offer that have not yet closed. Those are up 5% over last year. The median sales price comparing March of 2019 to March of 2020 is up 6.2% overall. That being said, if you're looking at new construction, you're in luck. That is only up 0.6%, not even 1%. Next, the total inventory of homes on the market currently is down 11%, which is concerning in my opinion, as we're already historically low on inventory. As you can see on the last slide, the month's supply of inventory is below 2 at 1.7 months. This number ideally should be over 4. So what does all this mean? First, we have very low inventory, a symptom of the current health crisis. But our pending sales are up, so buyers are still out in full force driving the inventory numbers down to critical levels. What does this mean for you, sellers? Get your home on the market now if you're looking to sell. Buyers are still out there and they're looking for your home. We don't know what's going to happen in the future. All we know is what's happening right now. So if you've been thinking about selling your home, my recommendation would be to go ahead and get it on the market. With record low inventories, a home priced right should sell for top dollar. My prediction going forward is if we are able to normalize our market in the next month or so, the impact on housing will be negligible, if any. In fact, I could realistically see a spike in inventory and prices due to the demand. If this drags on throughout the summer, I believe that we will have an impact not only on inventory, but on prices. So we're in a wait and see situation right now. I hope you found this information helpful. If you're wanting local housing information, leave me a comment below and I'll be sure to get back with you. Now don't forget to check out our free report on how to maximize the sale of your home during these times. You'll find a link in the description box right below. So stay safe out there, everyone. Reporting from the state capitol, this is Brian Stites with the Twin Cities Real Estate Guide, signing off.